Well, when am I to be sworn in?
Into what?
Your army.
Sorry, I haven't a petticoat brigade.
Well, then form one.
Haven't I enough troubles?
But surely you owe me that much. After I saved your life.
What could you do? You probably never fired a shot in your life.
You could teach me.
Come here. Closer.
So that you can put your arms around me.
Well, if you want to learn, the first thing you got to know is how to make a smooth, quick draw. In this neck of the woods, a man's age is measured by the number of split seconds he can take off his draw like this. See how I file off that front sight? That's so it won't catch in my holster. And don't stop to aim. You haven't time for that. Shoot with a sense of direction. Think you can remember that much?
I try.
See those leaves over there? Let's see how close you can come to one of them.
You mean you want me to try and put a hole through it? Like this? Or shall I just cut it off? Like this?
Well, I guess you'll catch on.
Shall I raise my right hand or kneel? Now, wait a minute, Sam Stahl. There's nothing in the regulations about this.
I mean it, Belle. I've meant it from the first minute I saw you.
I bet you've told that to every girl between here and St. Louis.
Saying it and meaning it are two different things.
When I want to be kissed, I'll let you know. In the meantime, keep your filthy hands off of me. Hello. Where are you off to?
Home.
Home?
Where else should we be going?
But, Ed, we can't go down there now. They'd only throw you back in jail again. And me, too.
That's no worse than hiding out here in the hills like gophers.
But we don't have to hide out. We can work with Captain Stahl. Go where he goes.
Is this your idea?
I haven't opened my mouth.
Do you realize you're suggesting that you become a common bandit?
Captain Stahl is not a bandit. He's a soldier.
No matter what you say or what he says, he's an outlaw with a price on his head. I've thought this all out. It's no use trying to excuse him or to excuse ourselves. We've acted like idiots.
That's not true. Sam's fighting for the South and everything it stands for. Aren't you?
Of course.
You see?
Haven't you caused enough trouble already? Why don't you tell her the truth? That you love this sort of thing. That fighting's in your blood. It's what you live for. If it wasn't for the South, it would be for something else. Anything else.
Don't you really mean that I'm not the kind of man you want your sister to have anything to do with? That I'm not a gentleman like Major Crail, for instance? You can correct me if I'm wrong, Captain.
Well, say that he's everything that you believe him to be. You've still got to remember that you're a woman, Bill. You're my sister. There isn't anything I wouldn't do for you except stand by and see you throw your life away. Now, please come home with me before it's too late.
I can't, Ed. I'll never go back. Not as long as there's a Yankee in this state. It's not just because they killed Father, burned our home, threw you in jail. It's bigger than that. It's what they're doing to people like us all over the South. What they'll do to Missouri, too, if we don't stop them.
You won't stop them this way. You'll only make things worse.
Would you rather crawl to them?
If necessary, yes.
You're my brother, Ed. I love you. I love you more than anything. But if you ever do, I hope I never see you again. Now go on. Go on home. And when you see Tom Crail, you can tell him there's one Shirley that isn't afraid of him or the whole North.